Hi, this is Lee Neubecker, president of Enigma Forensics, a computer forensics firm based here in Cook County in Chicago. And I have the pleasure of having our very own Cook County Clerk, Karen Yarbrough, here on the show to talk a little bit about what her office is doing to help keep people safe in light of the recent corona outbreak. Karen, thanks for being on the show.
Thank you, Lee. Well, you know, this is a really busy time for us. And we have a number of, we have our regular employees, mm-hmm. and then we have a lot of people, almost 8,000 people, mm-hmm. who will be involved in the election on the 17th. So we want everyone to be safe. So in the office, what we're doing is, first of all, we're educating people. Now, some of this stuff is just common sense. Mm-hmm. I mean, people should know to wash their hands. They absolutely should know that. They also should know that if you have to sneeze, mm-hmm. you don't sneeze out like that. You go like this. Okay? Yeah. I mean, didn't your mom teach you that? I mean, mine did. Yeah. So the education, or bringing it back to people on how we can keep safe. So mm-hmm. our people have, they have obviously Purell, they have the gloves mm-hmm. if they want to wear them. They also have, they clean their workstations, you know, mm-hmm. so we have everything that they need. And we have a big influx of people for several reasons, and especially in vitals mm-hmm. and in elections. And yep. so we want everyone to be safe.
Yeah, so with the election fast approaching, I know that previously you were on the show to talk about early voting mm-hmm. In trying to get people to pull a ballot so that they can vote from home. It's too late for that now, but what would you advise that people should do as they're heading to the polls?
Well, hopefully they'll have a card or some information on who they want to vote for. Mm-hmm. They're going to find our brand new voting machines there, and it'll probably take them all of 2 or 3 minutes to vote this time. So what the ease of voting, they're going to find friendly faces there mm-hmm. and people who are willing to help them. We have the touch screens, mm-hmm. and we also have paper ballots if people want to use them. But we're encouraging people to use the touch screen. If you want to use your finger, then you can wipe your finger off with the, and we have everything there.
Yeah, I mean,
absolutely, we have everything there. Mm-hmm. They could use a pen to do this. You know, they could use bring their own pen if they want to fill out a paper ballot. So, you know, again, we're telling people use some common sense here mm-hmm. as it relates to, you know, today and all through the last few days. What I've been doing is going to the early voting polling places. Mm-hmm. And so I've met all of the judges, and I see the way that they're greeting people. They're not shaking hands. They're mm-hmm. doing fist bumps or arm bumps, yeah, like that or whatever, but they are not shaking hands. So, you know, as I've looked at, and we've been looking at, you know, watching, yeah. what's coming out of Washington, what's coming out...
Even here in Chicago,
absolutely.
Yesterday we had the Prudential building.
Yeah, how about that? How about that? But you know what? For the most part, 80% of the people who contracted in the first place, they're going to be fine. Children are going to be fine. It's mm-hmm. people who have compromised systems mm-hmm. that have the problems, you know, and older people. I get all of that, but people can be safe. Yeah. And they can become, to, you know, use common sense and be safe.
Yeah, like not jump on an airline when you know you've tested positive.
I don't think you should do that.
For coronavirus.
Yeah, don't come to work sick. We're sending people home. Anybody's around there sniffling or what have you, mm-hmm. or they don't feel well, if they have a fever.
Yeah.
You know, if you got a fever, you ought to be at home.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be with us.
And just because you have a fever, you shouldn't be flipping out thinking you have coronavirus.
Not at all.
They say that you need to have 3 specific symptoms combined to worry about it. You need body aches.
Yes.
Fever.
Yes.
Plus respiratory problems.
Yes.
So if you don't have all 3 of those, don't bug your doctor. The doctors are under control.
Don't panic.
Unless you, if you have a fever that runs a while,
yeah.
you know, call,
well, then you
but,
should.
But don't assume that you have
then
corona.
I'm hoping we get some better information out of Washington, though. You know, there have been mixed messages there. So let's hope that we can get better information out of Washington, as well as what we need. You know, I noticed that our governor was pretty frustrated about, you know, his inner workings with the federal government on what we need in Illinois. So let's hope that they get that together.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Well, thanks for being on the show again.
Thank you.